LA a little bit now, a couple months, and I'm relatively young. I moved from the East Coast. I'm from Maryland. I told you to stay your ass in Maryland. Now I'm from Maryland, but I love LA a lot. LA's cool. LA has no shortage of cool elderly white women. It's great. I love the ratio. I love it. Every time I walk past the elderly white woman in the street and she smiles at me, I like to imagine I remind her of the Negro jazz player she had an affair with in the 60s. That's where my mind goes. Oh, my chubby checker. Let's hear this story. I don't know. It's hard being black in America, guys. It is. I don't care what Fox News tells you. It's fucking difficult. It's hard. Police brutality, it's just, we get brutalized in record numbers. It's amazing. It's crazy. But one silver lining, one good thing about being a black dude, especially this dark skin, I don't get sunburned, you guys. Yeah. It's magnificent. It's great. I thoroughly enjoy it. I feel bad for most of this room, though. Like, most of the people in here, you guys really get it bad. It's a strong California sun out here. I feel bad for you guys. But that's empathy. I don't experience it, but I feel bad for you guys to go through it. And I feel like we just need more empathy going both ways. Because, like, the relationship that black people have with the police is a lot like the relationship that white people have with the sun. Just like on a really intense day with no protection, someone might could die. It's a dark sun joke. We need empathy. Like, we need empathy going both ways. Because, like, if one of you lovely pale white people came up to me all red in the face and shoulders, all sunburned, it would be insensitive of me. It would be mean of me to be like, what the hell happened to you? The sun? Well, what did you do to the sun for the sun to do that to you? Look, I was outside all day today, too. I'm fine. The sun shines equally on all of us, okay? All right? All right, fine. I'll give you the benefit of the doubt. Next time you go outside during the daytime, I'll go and I'll stand between you and the sun. I'm immune to the sun's brutality, okay? I love doing this comedy thing. I want to be relatively famous. I want to be a little bit famous. I don't want to be too famous. I don't need all that. I want to be a little famous. I want to be famous enough that rappers know who I am, and that they use me as a reference for how dark the paint job on their cars. that's where I want to be at. Like, you turn on the radio, you hear the new feature song, you ride around in an old Subaru. My car is black as a whistle. Mama, I made it. New feature song. Racism, it sucks. And it's not just white people think everyone darker than a lunch bag is evil. Like, it's not that. Even black people hate black people. Like, that's how ingrained racism is in our society. Like, while I was living in New York, it was one night, me and my three buddies were walking down the street. We're all three dark-skinned dudes. They're all comics. And so we're walking down the street at night, and we see a group of white women in front of us. So my one buddy, Alex, he's like, man, look at these white chicks, man. They probably think we're gonna rob them or something like that. And I'm like, why would you assume that they already think we're gonna rob them? And he's like, nah, fuck that, watch this. So we get closer to them, and Alex is like, hey! Five! And one of the lead white chick was like, and he was just like, and just like we moved past him. And I was like, look, see, she didn't get all weird. Like, she gave you a high five. See, that means your suspicion meant nothing. And he's like, nah, Fuck that. That was an anomaly, son. So we get around them, and there's a group of black dudes in front of them, like over past them. So I'm like, all right, keep the gravy train moving. You know, high five these dudes right here. And he's like, nah, fuck that. I don't know them niggas. Racism is dumb, guys. It's really stupid. It's really dumb. But this isn't a racist audience. You guys are lovely. You guys are fun.
Yeah.
That's what it's all about. Thanks, Ash.
You're welcome.
Yeah, they're all about it. I don't know. I get excited about really dumb stuff. No, I'm going to skip that for right now. I'm going to do what I'm doing. This is my goddamn show. Oh, that's the one I have to do. Okay, so I don't drink alcohol. There's beer, drink it, please. But none for me, I don't do that. I don't drink alcohol. And some people try to make me feel better about it. Like if we go out to a bar or a social setting, they're like, Eric, you don't drink? That's all right. You were probably just born in the wrong decade, Eric. You're probably born in the wrong era. You should have been born during Prohibition. Which would have been cool, right? Just me running around during 1920s America for Prohibition. Because not only was alcohol banned from any and all places during Prohibition, guys, so were black people. Unfortunate stain on our country's history. Another fun thing. It's like the news has been the same for 100 years. Another fun thing alcohol and black people had in common during Prohibition, both were swallowed behind closed doors.
Oh!
That's a good one.
Yeah.
I like that one.
By adventurous white people. So,
yeah!
You know what? Maybe I should have been born during Prohibition. Yeah. Maybe that would have worked out. I get super excited about dumb stuff. But not this show. I'm excited about the show. You guys ready for more show? Thank you guys so much. I'm Eric Owusu. I'll be your host. I'll be fucking with y'all in between the comics. So get ready for that. But coming up next is a great comedian. She's very funny. Good buddy of ours. She's very bubbly and exciting. Very funny. Give it up for Rachel Scanlon, guys. Rachel!